forecast calls for occasional spring showers this morning, followed by
hey, Dad.
This afternoon. Today's high.
Anybody can have a stroke. Anybody is at risk for a stroke, really.
Near 57 degrees. Tonight, more cloud cover with a low of 39. More rain
Dad?
Tomorrow with the chance
okay?
of thunderstorms and a high of only 49.
Time is very important when it comes to stroke. There's certain windows that we have to meet for certain types of treatments, and the sooner that we catch it, the better.
I'm going to call 911.
30 to 64, please.
My name is Erin Lewis. I am a registered nurse. I am also the stroke program coordinator at UNC Rex. Time is brain because the longer that parts tissue of your brain is not receiving blood flow, it's going to die. So the quicker you intervene, the more of that brain tissue that you save.
My name is Aaron Wenzel, and I am an assistant chief here at Wake County EMS, and I serve as our clinical quality officer. Sometimes people are afraid to call EMS because they just don't know. That's why we're here. If you think you might be having a stroke or an emergency, call us. We can come out. If there's nothing wrong and we don't need to go to the hospital and you don't want to go to the hospital, we don't have to take you to the hospital. But it's always better to call and be safe.
And so if you were to seek care immediately, there's a chance that we could give you a clot buster or we could do a procedure to go remove the clot and we would save so much more territory. Versus if your arm was weak and you ignored it for half of a day, by the time you got to us, all of that territory that the blood vessel is supplying blood to could already be dead. And so even if we could remove the clot, it wouldn't make a difference to you. And what really matters is how you are when you walk out of the hospital after having a stroke.
So I think the most important things as it comes to realizing or suspecting that you may be having a stroke is the importance of calling 911 and utilizing EMS as your transport to the hospital. That's helpful for a number of factors. One, we can get to you and get the treatment to you usually quicker than you can get to the hospital. Yes, you may be able to drive to the hospital before we might be able to get you there, but we're starting that treatment earlier. We're recognizing the symptoms earlier. We're able to give the hospital a heads up so they're ready for us when we get there versus if you just show up to the ER honking your horn. It's not like what happens on TV. They don't all run outside and grab you out of the car and all that stuff.
When the EMS providers are bringing a patient to us that they suspect is having a stroke, they call all it right, in so as a stroke alert.
Stroke alert.
Once that charge nurse receives that call, they then alert and activate their stroke team and notify them the estimated time of arrival of that stroke patient. And we meet EMS there at that stretcher, the stroke nurse, the emergency room nurse, the neurologist, and the ED doctor, and we exchange a short handoff and get the patient onto the launch pad stretcher to prepare the code stroke to be activated and move towards the CT room for brain imaging. So UNC Rex is a certified comprehensive stroke center, and that means that we are required to meet certain quality metrics and certain standards in our care of all stroke patients. Because we're certified, that tells our EMS agencies that they know we have all the right resources, all the right imaging capabilities, and that we are held to a certain standard of care for our stroke patients, and so they can have confidence that they're bringing a patient somewhere that they're going to get the care that they need and they're going to get it rapidly. But at UNC Rex within the hospital, we have neuro-hospitalists on site and on call 24/7. And so a lot of hospitals in the country utilize telestroke, which means when a patient comes in with a stroke, the emergency room doctors are using an audio and visual device or computer to teleconference with a physician off-site to make the decisions. At Rex, we have those specialized neurologists in-house. So you're gonna have a neurologist that sees you and then continues to follow you until you are ready to go home. Our care and our purview of stroke starts at home in the community. We're very focused on community education, community knowledge around stroke recognition and seeking treatment immediately. And then we follow up with you after you've had a stroke. And so we start in the community and we end in the community with all of our hospital care in the middle.